You guys, I got three new tattoos. One, two, and three. I'm so excited to share this with y'all. There's gonna be a complete vlog coming up very soon, and I can't wait for y'all to watch it. Hi, what's up everyone? Welcome back to my channel. Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I am finally sharing this huge makeup haul that I've done a while back, and I have promised it to y'all since so long, and every video I get a follow up on that, like, when is that haul coming? So today is the holy day when I'm finally sharing it with y'all. I have a ton of makeup, like a lot of makeup that I've shoved in this dabba, and it's like full to the brim, and there's so many new launches that I like ordered and like piled it in, and so many things that I've kept on purchasing ever since I promised y'all that haul. So I'm so excited to dive into this. So if you're interested, then continue watching. But also, if you're new here, then please take a moment and hit the subscribe button and join the Sara squad. If you enjoy honest beauty reviews and relatable makeup content and fun vlogs, you'll have a great time here. And also hit the bell icon right next to it so that every time I upload a video, you get notified. I also have a small little thing I want to ask y'all and need a quick poll from you guys in the comment section. So please help your girl out. I have been planning a completely new series for December. If you have been following me for a while, you'll know that Christmas is my favorite time of the year, and I enjoy vlogging on Christmas. But this year I thought I'd change it up and do like a proper vlogmas and do 25 days of Christmas. That would mean a new YouTube video every single day for 25 days from the 1st of December to the 25th of December. So let me know in the comments if that's something that interests you. Do you like the sound of that? Would you be interested in watching new content? It would have everything, a lot of makeup, a lot of skincare, and a lot of hauls and a lot of vlogs. So if you're interested, let me know in the comments so I can start planning, filming a lot of content for you. Diving straight into it, the first product I have are these new water activated eyeliners from Debashree Beauty. So Debashree is an Indian content creator. She's a beauty content creator, I'm sure you all already know. And she's come up with her own beauty line, which is super amazing and very, very exciting. So I went ahead and bought a complete bundle from her makeup line. So it includes four eyeliners. These are really bold shades. Let me show you all what it looks like. I have been trying it out with and without makeup, and I mean, I have my thoughts about these, and I did ask y'all on my community tab, and a lot of y'all want to see the review. So yes, I will be reviewing them for y'all. So I have four shades right here. I have this bright pink color, this neon orange, this yellow, and this red. So I got one of the bundles. The bundles retail for 3,000 rupees, somewhere close to that, and individually you get them for 800 each. So I want to try more shades. They're basically water activated liners. So what you need is a brush, a little bit of water, and then like mix it and apply it. Like I said, I have my thoughts. I will share them in my review video, so stay tuned for that. But this is the first thing that I got. Next, I have a couple of stuff from Wet n Wild that I shopped from HOK Makeup. So the first thing I have is this bronzer right here, the Wet n Wild Color Icon Bronzer in the shade Watch Shady Beaches. It's the bronzer on my face right now. Really like the pan on this one. It's a nice, generous pan, and also the shade is really good because it complements my skin tone really well. I've done this glam look today and also filmed it, so I'm going to be trying this new makeup out for y'all. A lot of like makeup, so then all of this in action you will see in that video. So this is 550 rupees, but if I'm not mistaken, I got this and the Wet n Wild natural finish setting spray, as well as this Wet n Wild eyeshadow palette in a bundle from HOK Makeup. So HOK Makeup has these very affordable bundles. If you look at it as a whole, it's very inexpensive, because the bronzer is 550, this eyeshadow palette is somewhere close to 800 if I'm not wrong, 600, and this setting spray is about 600 as well. So for all these three products, I paid 1,000 rupees on HOK Makeup, which is why I love their deals. The natural finish setting spray is something I've not tried at all. It's still in petty packaging. I don't really like the matte finish setting spray that much from Wet n Wild, but I wanted to give this one a try. And the eyeshadow palette is something that's on my eyes right now. It has a wide variety of colors. For 600, it's quite a good palette because it gives you like a diverse range of shades. You have your neutrals right here on top, and then you have some bold pops of color over here. So I really enjoy Wet n Wild products. They're also cruelty free, so it's a total plus. Then I got some new makeup from PAC. So I got the PAC Micro Finish Makeup Fixer. This used to be my favorite makeup fixer. And it's like a big bottle and it costs about $835. I don't know, once I ran out of that, it gets over very fast. Because the nozzle on this is like a perfume bottle. So you end up spritzing way more than you need and it gets over really, really fast. But I love this. It sets your makeup beautifully, feels good on the skin, and just in general as a product, I absolutely love it. So I got myself a refill now, and I also got a refill of my PAC Spotlight Concealer, which I realize is like the most full coverage concealer I have ever used. That also used to brighten my under eyes till I went ahead and got the wrong shade. So I don't know if they've expanded their shades or renamed their shades or reformulated or what is it, but the last PAC Spotlight Concealer I had was number 13, so I went ahead and got number 13. And this 13 is way darker than the one I have and the one I'm used to using. This is yellow, like really, 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 really yellow, like very yellow undertone. Like it would not conceal anything for me. It just makes my under eyes look super yellow, makes me look like an Oompa Loompa only. So I have to really mix it up with another concealer to try to balance the shade. So I'm so bummed that I got a wrong shade, because this is 600 rupees and I really need to make it work. And I absolutely love the formula, but I'm so stupid that I didn't open it and see it's the wrong shade. And I got this from the store, like I got the PAC stuff from a local shop. So I could have possibly paid attention, but me being me, I didn't. Last thing I got from PAC is this. This is a PAC Big Lashes Mascara. It has two sides, so you get like a thinner wand, which I absolutely love, which is for the lower lashes. And usually I don't enjoy such, you know, double-sided thing. It's just more effort. But I really like this one because it clings to your lashes really, really well. And the other one is also a very, very nice, like bushy sort of a wand. If you can see, it's somewhere around 595 or something. And I really like the formula on this one as well. It's soon going to be my favorite mascara. I'm wearing this right now on my lashes, but I've layered it with the L'Oreal Lash Paradise. Next, I got some new makeup from Milani. I also shopped for this on HOK Makeup. So Milani is a brand which is very, very, very famous internationally as well as in India. They make really good quality products from what I've seen in reviews, and also after trying all of this, I enjoyed using all of this. The only thing is that when it comes to India, it's super expensive. Like, I mean, it's frightfully expensive, because I know for a fact that in the US, it's like chindi, it's very, very inexpensive in dollars. But in India, like this setting spray was 1000 rupees, this blush is 1000 rupees, this liner is 600 bucks, almost close to those prices. And that's a lot of money for Milani, you know, but you get some great quality products. So I got the Milani Make It Last setting spray. This is what I paid 1000 rupees for. I'm a little disappointed because it's a very teeny tiny bottle. I was expecting more, like it's 60 ml, I know. I've used it today. I mean, I don't know yet if I love it or what it is, because I need to try it more. But I've heard great, great things about it. I just find it a little too expensive. Next, I got a blush from them. Milani blushes have always been on my bucket list, something I've always wanted to buy, because they look absolutely pretty, and not just that, they last really long. I've been using this ever since I got it, and I absolutely love this one. This color is Wild Rose. It's a nice peachy pinky undertone. It's the blush I have on my face right now. Looks pretty, is luxurious. It's just 1000 rupees for a blush, but I think it's really worth it. And lastly, I got a Milani Color Statement lip liner. This is in the shade Spice. So it's also a beautiful packaging and everything, aesthetic of it, very, very pretty. The color is very nude, okay? Let me just swatch it for y'all so y'all can see what the color looks like. It's pretty darn nude. Like on my lips, it looks as close to my lips but better. So I think this is a perfect lip liner for if you're looking for something which is so close to your lips and it doesn't like make the nude lipsticks look like a different shade altogether while also not washing you out. So it's like perfect for underlining your lips when you are using a lipstick that tends to wash you out. Next, I went ahead and got a couple of Miss Claire soft matte lip creams, like a lot of them. I was just feeling so nostalgic when I was in the store, because Miss Claire soft matte lip creams is all I used to use when I started my channel, and also like, you know, in my college days and everything. So I really wanted to get my hands on all the shades that would possibly look good on brown skin without makeup as well as with makeup. So I asked y'all in one of my videos, and y'all want to see the swatches on these lipsticks. So I'm going to do a dedicated video for all of these lipsticks and swatch them with and without makeup the way we always do lipstick swatches on this channel. So yeah, I just want to share two shades right now that I've been loving. This is the brownie nude color, which is number 63. Looks very, very nice and very different sort of a brownie nude. Literally wearing it every single day. And the other color is this number 10, which is a red shade. This used to be the red shade I used to literally wear every time in my videos. So that's why, you know, because of the nostalgia. So I will give you all of the swatches in one of the videos. Hopefully, we are doing 25 days of Christmas, then it will be a part of that. Next, I got some oldie but goodie Maybelline products. For the first time ever, I got my hands on the Maybelline Fit Me foundation. I have been using it on my channel for a while now, like past couple of videos. But before that was the first time I bought a Fit Me for myself. I got the shade 330 Toffee, and I have been enjoying, thoroughly enjoying using the Fit Me foundation. Honestly, I hopped on the bandwagon quite late because I used to not be able to like the texture of it when I had a lot of textured skin going on. It used to not give me the most flattering effect. But now this shade matches me perfectly and I don't have that much texture, so it looks really good on my skin. And I got the Colossal Kajal because old school again, nostalgia and everything. When I was shopping for affordable makeup at the store, I was like, I have to get my hands on a Colossal Kajal because it's been a while. Next, I got a couple of lipsticks from Swiss Beauty. These are their pure matte lipsticks. I absolutely love Swiss Beauty when it comes to like really affordable makeup. Miss Claire and Swiss Beauty have to be like my favorites. So these are like soft touch packaging. I absolutely love it, like so luxurious. Just look at the component of this lipstick. It's soft touch, and this is the first shade that I have is coral red. So it's a very bold red color, coral, very, very bold and pop of color. And the second shade I have is much more wearable, and this is the shade Hazelnut. So it's your regular brownie mauvey nude shade. So love both the colors. Of course, Hazelnut is more usable than coral red, but if you're into such corally sort of pinky red shades, you would love this one as well. Next product I got is the Inside Cosmetics 3-in-1 primer. This is the Prime Protect and Moisturize long lasting oil free primer, and it's actually really good. It makes my makeup last really long. It has a very silicone-y base, so it is tacky in nature. It makes my makeup last really long, and it also doesn't make me oily or sweaty throughout the day, so I can't really complain. And it costs only ₹240, so it's a great purchase. Next, I have the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer, and this is in the shade C12. I've been wanting to try this product out for the longest time, and so I did today. That video is coming up very soon, like I already said. And yeah, I've tested if it's worth the hype. It costed me about 550-600 rupees, so y'all need to watch that video to know what I exactly feel about this one. Next, I got this Savannah Colors Makeup Studio Pro Blush Contour and Highlight. I was doing a full beginner's makeup kit under ₹2000, and I wanted to give you all an affordable option, so this was the perfect option. I will leave the link for you all over here. So I like this palette because it gives you a lot of variety of colors and also a lot of mattes as well as shimmers. You can use them as blush, bronzer, highlight and eyeshadows, which is what I've shown in that video. So you all will be able to know how to use this to its maximum potential. It's only ₹500. So you're getting good value for money. You will be able to do a full face glam makeup with just this one palette. And lastly, to finish it off, we have a lipstick, and this is the one by Makeup Revolution. This is their Satin Matte Lipstick in the shade Fling. It's a beautiful nude shade. It's actually one of my go-to nude shades at the moment because it looks so, so beautiful with as well as without makeup. I absolutely love this color. It's very, very different sort of a nude shade. On top, don't consider this swatch, consider this swatch. Okay, this one has a little bit of another lipstick mix. Can you see how pretty it looks? It's nice, peachy, nude color, and it doesn't wash you out even without makeup. If you're my skin tone, it's not going to wash you out. It'll look beautiful, breathtaking on you. The formula of this lipstick is also really stunning. It's about 500, 600 something, and it's a really good lipstick for you to check out. Alright, you guys, so with that, I complete today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching everything that I finally hauled in makeup since a while. Let me know in the comments which was your favorite product from all of this. Have you tried any of this? Is there any new makeup that is coming? And I have absolutely no clue about, because I want to try new makeup, play with new makeup, but nothing exciting is launching only, yaar. So let me know in the comments if y'all have the gup and I don't yet. And also please let me know about what you think of 25 days of Christmas. Should I do it? Should I not? I need to know from you guys. If you like today's video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. For today's video, the Sara Squad shout out goes to Jumela Rafiq. Thank you so much for watching and supporting my channel. If you want to be a part of next video Sara Squad shout out, all you gotta do is hit the subscribe button, the bell icon right next to it and also leave a comment down below saying hashtag Sarah Squad, and you get a chance to be a part of my next video, Sarah Squad Shoutout. I will see you guys very soon in another video. Bye guys, take care, I love you.